Well, hi, I'm Jason Tresser. I teach in the biology department here at Biola University, and we're doing a video today about the relationship between science and Christian faith. And we've got a number of faculty members from different departments, and we're talking about the relationship between Christianity and faith and the need to train Christians to enter fields of science and health and be leaders in those fields. So before we do our conversation here, we're going to take a minute and introduce everybody around the table and talk about what department and what you teach. So you start us off, John.
Okay, I'm John Bloom. I'm a chair of the physics department. Well, it's actually chemistry, physics, and engineering. My main day job is teaching physics.
I'm Danelle Campbell, full-time faculty in the nursing department. I teach primarily senior nursing students, management and leadership, and community public health.
I'm in the biology department. I teach mostly genetics, biochemistry, and developmental biology.
Hi, my name is Hyuna Lee, and I'm in the biological sciences department, and I'm one of the new faculties. And I'm teaching currently microbiology lab and general science.
Hi, my name is Jonah Chang, and I am an assistant professor in the chemistry department. And I teach chemistry classes for freshmen and also for seniors.
So there's a lot of people today who have an understanding that there's a conflict between science and Christianity. And teaching at a university like this, we all have somehow made peace with that. And John Bloom has actually written a book recently called The Natural Sciences, A Student's Guide. And so I was wondering, John, if you'd start our discussion off talking about how, as Christians, we resolve this perceived conflict between science and faith.
Well, the conflict is a bit of a myth. Sure, there's been tensions on how do you interpret things over time. But if you look historically at the relationship between Christianity and science, it's been more of a partnership. Because as Christians, we're seeking truth. In science, you're seeking, you know, truth. What's the physical world like? So the two really work together well as a partnership. I think that's how we all, you know, approach it here at Biola.
Yeah, I feel like the definition of science has gotten too narrow, that science now means you have to do science with a certain worldview, and that if we can, as Christians, we could do science if science is means investigating the natural world, and we have a toolkit that we can use to do that. I feel like the conflict comes when you impose a certain worldview that has to be done. You have to look at science this certain way. As Christians, I think that's probably what we have a conflict with, is saying that you have to look at science just through a naturalistic lens, just chemistry and physics, and not give any room for other explanations besides that.
It's interesting in the history of the relationship for Christianity and science. The Christianity actually gave the right lens or the right worldview for that perspective. Mm-hmm. It was kind of stolen by the naturalists later, as though, no, you have to look at it only naturalistically. But why should we expect the physical world to be constant and fixed? Because it was created by a God who set it up that way. So there's a lot of Christian principles that are in the that affect how we view the world that science uses. So that's why a partnership is a good way to see it.
Yeah. We can expect the natural world to be rational and repeatable because God is rational and has created a repeatable world.
Yeah. Right.
Well, you know, for me, I grew up thinking that science was interesting, awe-inspiring, and incredibly useful. So the challenge as I got older and went further in school was to try to figure out how to marry the structural part, the part that's really scientific, with some sort of a practical application that I could make meaningful not only in my career, but also in the caring for people. And I think that's where Christianity really served as a wonderful bridge, because it really lent itself to answering some of the questions that science didn't completely answer.
Mm-hmm. And what do you do with what you know? You apply it to help others.
Yes.
Yeah, that's a huge one.
Biola University offers a variety of biblically-centered degree programs, ranging from business to ministry to the arts and sciences. Visit biola.edu to find out how Biola could make a difference in your life.